Hello everyone, my name is Emri Nibikira. I'm here to help you go through this training on continuous integration using GitHub Actions. What you see on the left side of my screen is the tutorial webpage, and they should have gotten the link from the previous session in this workshop. On the right side, you see in my terminal where we'll be typing commands. So as you can see on this tutorial webpage, we assume that you have some basic background with command line, such as how to execute shell scripts, how to run Python scripts. We also assume you have gone through all previous sessions in this workshop. And there is also a couple of skills we'll be focusing on. First one would be how to make a script exit correctly, and next how to build efficiently a CI/CD workflow. We also try to understand how GitHub runners handle your jobs, as well how to protect secret information while allowing jobs to run. Below you find a list of lessons we'll be covering. I recommend to go to setup first, to set up some tools we will need before we start the main lessons. So now you can see on the setup what I have. There is also prerequisites that you already have a GitHub account, a valid GitHub account, and also a valid SSH key associated with your GitHub account, as well as Git working on your computer. The first tool we will need is from Python. Since we'll be learning how to make scripts exit correctly, we will need to test exit codes with this PyTest, which is a Python testing tool. So for now, we just recommend to install it in case you don't have. So you can do a quick check by just typing this Python -c import PyTest. In my case, you see it returns nothing. This means in my case, it is installed. If it's not the case for you, I have left a link here. You can click on it and follow instructions in order to have it installed on your computer. A second tool we need is this ACT. And this will allow us to run GitHub Actions locally. So we need it installed before we start our main lessons. If you don't know about it, don't worry, you can find instruction here how to install it. You just have to click and this will direct you to our page. You can find different methods of how to install it. So once you've installed it, don't worry, you can just check this my terminal. What you see, I'm using version 0.2.0.19. It also means that it's installed on my computer. And this ACT works together with Docker. If you don't know what Docker is, don't worry. You just install it on your computer. I have also put a link here. If you follow this link, you can see for different platforms how to install Docker and proceed with installation. Once it's done, you can do likewise. And then what you see here is Docker Let's Check version. I'm using version 19.03.8, which means Docker is installed. So if you might have need to use sudo when you run a Docker. But there is also a workaround if you don't want to preface the Docker command with sudo. You can follow this link. There is the last thing we need to set up. So we need the code, the material we'll use in this training. the first thing to do is to create a new project on GitHub. And then we will use this name, virtual-pipelines-event-selection. What to do? You go to your GitHub personal account. Here you will see my username and my personal Git account. You should put yours. And you will find a plus icon here and new repository. And then you will find your username slash and the name of the repository. So let's call it virtual pipelines event selection. Then by default, it should be a public repository. If this is not the case, please change it to public just to easy communication with your fellow and with your mentors as well. And last thing to do is to click on create repository, and then this will be created as you can see here. So before we continue here, let's go back to the setup page. So we've gone through this and we've created the repository. Now let's get the material now. The time is here. We want to get the material. What we need is just to clone the material for someone else. As you can see, it's on GitHub, but with a different username, which is the RCF training. For now, let's just get it from there. I'm cloning it, it's done. I can check what is in virtual. You see there is files there. But what we want is to add the code on our personal GitHub account, right? So to do so, you need to change the name of the existing remote. Let's check the name first of the existing remote. There is a nice command from Git, remote-v. You can see here the URL of this repository. What we'll do, we will go and use this command, git remote set URL origin, and then we put the URL. We can get it from here. Make sure you are on SSH, and then I can copy and paste. Now I can check again with git remote minus v. Now you see that I am on my GitHub account. There is a last step, is to put the content of this repository on my personal Git account. That is, here we'll do git push minus u origin and the name of the branch, which is master. You can see here now it's pushing with a new branch master. Let's see how now it looks. Just refresh this page, refreshing the page. Oh, I have all my files here. And that's it. So you've succeeded to add the code on your GitHub account. If you are having issues, please don't hesitate to come to us. There is a Mattermost channel. You go there and we'll be also there to help you. Thank you and see you in the next video.